Okay, hi everyone. Today we will be discussing about F5 upgrade. That is one of the most important step. So people have questions like how to upgrade F5. So we will cover step by step in this video, like how to upgrade F5 and what things needs to be taken care. So first step, when you need to upgrade F5, you need to take care, like you need to download software. So let's say you have version 12 and you need to upgrade to version 13 or version 14. So first of all, you need to download the latest software from F5. So I will show you step by step, like how to download new ISO and that you need to import. After that, we will covering about reactivate license. Like why license needs to be reactivated. If license does not get reactivated, it can cause issues. Your configuration would not load properly. Third step, once we download ISO, we need to import it into F5. So we will cover this step. Fourth one, we need to install the latest version in our boot location. Like in Cisco also, we have boot concept. If I need to install and reboot to another location, I need to first install that image in boot location. And another step which is important is we need to force offline the box. So I will talk about why we need to force offline and what things we need to take care of when we are upgrading F5 in HA. After that, last step is we need to change the active boot location so that it can be upgraded to 13 version, 14 or 15. So these six are the general steps. Now let me come into seventh step when the device gets upgraded. So when we talk about, we have done six steps. Now there are more steps which you need to take care in upgrade. Seventh step is you need to release offline mode. Because when we force offline, the box got offline and box got upgraded. After that, we need to release them it offline. After that, we need to force to standby so that other box get upgraded. So we need to force standby the non-upgraded node. So we will perform practically all the steps. You can say non-upgraded F5 or not. After that, you need to test the new version. See if everything is working, because in HA that is an advantage, right? You can test for 5 minutes. If everything is working, you upgrade the second box. After that, we will upgrade the next other node. That are the 10 steps which we need to follow. So let's perform step by step how to download, how to reactivate license and everything. So first step is F5 upgrade download. First one is we need to download. So guys, everyone in our environment, we are taking two F5s. So let's say this is F5.1 and this is F5.2. Both the boxes are connected to switch and these are in HA. One box is active and one box is standby in our architecture. And we have a task in our environment to upgrade F5 from version 12 to version 13. Right now we are running version 12. I need to upgrade to version 13. So what are the things we need to take care? So in this case, why we are performing steps is because at a time we will upgrade standby box. Once it's upgraded, we will force, like let's say this is active and this is standby. So at a time, we will first upgrade standby. Once it's upgraded, we will fail over all traffic to standby and make it active. So we will go upgrade steps one by one. So first step, which I was talking, was download, like how we do download. So for download, it's very easy. Let me show you download steps. So for download, let's say my task is, I can say my task is, I need to upgrade F5 from version 12 to version 13. In that case, my first task is, I will go to https://downloads.f5.com. And I will see version 13 image. So let me show you. I will open Google Chrome and I will show you how to download. So you will go to downloads.f5.com. Then I will log in. Just let me log in. So I will log in using my account. So you need to have account, active account for the same. You can create account on f5.com. So see, here I need to go and you will get downloads option. So you will click here, find a download. So next step would be, I will go and find a download to upgrade. So in this step, you will be getting, like, it's your choice. Either you need to upgrade to Virtual Edition or a TMOS. So let's say I need to upgrade to version 13. So I will go to version 13 tab. So you need to take care. You need to go to Big IP product family. I will go here. So you can select the image. So latest one is 13.1.3. So I will go here. I will see what is the version. So let's say I need to upgrade into 13.1.3.5. I will click on this because it's my hardware box. So I will go to 13.1. And here you will get it. So this is the image which I required. So I will go here and I will click, and you need to select the download location. Let's say you can use any location and download will start. So this way, first step, you need to download. After that, once download is completed, what is the next step? So our next step is, second step is, we need to export or backup the configuration. So when we are upgrading, this is very, very important step. So we have downloaded the image. Now our step is to take a backup. So what we will do, I will take UCS backup. So that if any challenge comes, I can take backup and restore it and roll back it. So what I will do, I will go to F5 and I will go to System Archive tab. So I will create one UCS backup. I will go to System Archive tab and I will create a UCS backup, which I will say upgrade before upgrade. You can give the name before upgrade F5. That's it. And you need to finish it. So once backup is done, Then we will come to the next step. So what we have done so far is we have downloaded an image and we have taken the backup. And you need to save this backup in your desktop so you can download it. Because after upgrade, sometimes device does not come up. So you can download it. So once it's done, you need to see what is the version number. So right now it's starting. Let me see another device. What is this version is? So you can see the version from system configuration device. So I will be right now it's 12.1.0. So I will be upgrading to 13.1.3.5. So now, next important step, we have taken the backup. Next step is we need to reactivate the license. This is important one. So question arises is in which cases this is required? In which case this is required? So let's come into that point. So there is a condition where license reactivation is required. So let's come into that. So license reactivation is required in one condition only. So that it will avoid your upgrade problem. So license reactivation is required. First, to understand this, you need to have two concepts. So there are two concepts for license reactivate. One is license check date, and one is service check date. So before license reactivate, you need to see what is the license check date and what is the service check date. So what is the difference between license check date and service check date? First, we need to understand this. So let's go to service check date first. Service check date. This is important one. So service check date is basically located in Big IP license file. So you can see from that. So in this, what does it specify is, it will say generally when license was last activated. So that's what service check date defines. So service check date is basically located in Big IP license file. And as a definition, it says that service check date is that date when the license was last activated, or the date when the service contract for the device expires. So let's say I have a license for, say, let's say I have an active contract that ends on December 31. Okay. Let's say I have an active which gets expired or ends on December 13, but I licensed a device on June 30. So what would be my service check date? So service check date would be June 30. It is that date when the license was last activated. That is as easy that. So whenever you reactivate the license, service check date gets updated. So that is important. Service check date is that date when the license was last activated. Okay. That is what. So we are discussing here service check date. And license check date. So we are discussing these two steps. What is the difference between that? Then there is one condition which I will tell you. So this was license when last activated. That is as simple as that. And what is license check date? License check date is a static date. It do not change, which is built into the software, into big IP software. So whenever F5 release, it will have one license check date with it. Let's say big IP release 16 version, 16.00. So it will have one license date. So license check date is a static date built into the software for big IP. So how to see license check date and service check date? So for service check date, what I will do is I will go to Google and I will search. There is one article, which is K7727F5. This is very, very important. So let's say I need to upgrade my version to 13. I have 12 and I need to upgrade it into 13.1.3. So I need to see what is service check date and what is license check date for the same. So in this case, I will go to this article and I will see what is the license. So see, this is the table. You will see license check date. This is the table where you will see. Let's say I need to upgrade it into 13. So when was last license check date was? This is very, very important, guys. Before upgrade, you need to see whether you require license check upgrade or not. Do we need to reactivate the license? So you need to check license check date and service check date. Let's say I need to upgrade into 13. So I will go to Big IP and I will see what is the license check date. So license check date is 2017-09-12. So it's 12th September 2017. Okay. So you will go to this article and you will see the license check date. Depends on your version which you are upgrading. So now let me write this. So what I will do is I will go to license check date and I will mark it as, let me write it what was there. So I will say license check date is for 13 version 2017-09-12. 2017-09-12. Now I need to see service check date. So how to see service check date? So for service check date, I will log in into F5 and I need to run one command. So what I will do is I will go to my PuTTY and take a PuTTY. So I will say 192.168.137.50. I'm not upgrading this. So what is the version? IP address, I will be upgrading 137.51. Let's log in into that. So I will go 192.168.137.51. I will just delete this and I will just. So here, what I will do is, I'm just increasing font size so that you can understand how to say it. So I will log in. Then what I will do is, right now which configuration? So it's present on cd/config. So you need to go to cd/config like this. You need to first go like this. It's already there because I have run into that. Then you need to run this command grep. Service check date, then you have to run this command, then you need to go to where I need to search. So I need to search on bigip.license file. So you will get service check date. So this is the command which you need to run. Grep service check date, and service check date is present on bigip.license. This is how you see. So let's say now we have got both service check date and license check date. So what I will do is, what was my license check date? So my license check date was for 13 version was 2017. Nine, 12. And what is my service check date? Service check date is, I will go again to putty and say it. 2012. Sorry, it's 2021 0 to 13. I will minimize it. 2021. 2021. 0 to 13th Feb. I did license reactivation. So it's saying that service check date is when license was last reactivated. So this is two dates which you are cleared now. Now there is a condition in which case license reactivation is needed. So here comes the condition, license reactivation is needed when service check date is earlier than license check date. That is as simple as that. If service check date is earlier than license check date, which is built into software which I have searched you, then you need to reactivate the license. If service check date is not earlier than license check date, then no need. That is very, very important. If you don't check this, then your upgrade can get failed. So you need to take care that service check date should not be earlier than license check date. If it is earlier, then you need to reactivate the license. So in our case, service check date is not earlier because service check date is 2021 and license check date was 2013 year, correct? So 2021 is greater than 2013, right? We searched 13 version and that it was, sorry, 2017 it was. So let me clear it. So it was 2017. So my service check date is 2021 because I reactivated the license on 2021 and my license check date is 2017. So service check date is greater than 2017. So I don't need to reactivate my license. That is important one. So once you do it, if you need to do license reactivate, how you can do it? So you will go to system, then license tab, then you can just reactivate. Here you need to have a key and you can just reactivate using automatic or manual, that's it. If you require, because service check date is earlier, then only it's required. Okay. Now let's come into third step. So we have done, we have downloaded. We have checked the license check, whether reactivation is required or not. Then I need to import ISO image into both F5 because I need to upgrade both F5. So how to import it? So for importing, it's very easy. So let's perform this step. Third step is importing latest image, latest ISO image into F5. So I will show you both GUI and CLI. So in CLI, what you can do is, suppose your image is present on your desktop. So you can take WinSAP and shift version 13 image to shared images in F5 directory. So if you log in into WinSAP or into F5, and you can go to shared images. And you can just transfer version 13 into that. So how we can do is, let's say I want to upgrade 13 version. Okay, first I need to import it. So I will log in into WinSAP and I will show you where we need to do it. So I will log in. Root. So I will go to root, then shared directory, shared, and I will go to images tab. So this is where you will need to upgrade and import it. So before upgrading, you should have image in that directory. So from here only you will see on F5. If you have not imported it, you will not see it. Either you can just do this, F5 automatically will import it, or you can import it through GUI. So see, I have 13 version already imported in my shared images directory. Then I will jump in and I will go to system tab. All the upgrade steps will be done in software management. So you need to go into system, software management, and all the things you will see related to upgrade. You don't need to go into any other tab. So all the upgrades will be done in system software management tab. So I've deleted this and I will show you. So you will go to system software image list. So guys, can you see this? I've imported that into shared images, shared/images, and I'm able to see. So installed is the current version. What is the boot location? SD 1.1, which is active. And I have one available image which I need to install so that I can upgrade the box. So before upgrading it, I need to have this image available on both the boxes. So let's check, this is standby. The same should be in another box. So I will go here. So can you see this? Same is available on this. So we have both the images, 13 and available image. So we are import. So our import step is done. Okay, guys. Now, what we need to do. I will delete this. Now our fourth step is, we need to install this. Because it's install this image into F5. So what we can do is, I will go to available images and import into new volume. Right now my image was on SD1.1. So I need to import into new directory, which is, let's say, new volume SD1.2. There are three volumes by default. So because this is VMware, I will not able to see. But if it's an hardware box, by default, there are three volumes. SD1.1. There are three boot location which comes default in F5 box. So 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3. So in VMware, because I do not have new volume, I will create it manually and install it. So what I will do is, I will go again into PuTTY and I will do this command. I need to run install. I'll go to tmsh. I will run this command. Install sys software image. Then I will give new image and I will run this command create volume. Then you need to define volume. My new volume is HD 1.2. So you can say, so it's giving me error. So let's see why it's giving error. So I'm just running this command install. Because let me show you first GUI, like why from GUI I cannot do it. So let's say, because in your physical environment, when you are not in your lab, you can just do install and you need to type volume set. So in my case, I do not have volume. Are you getting me? So first I need to create a volume because it's a Vimware box, which I am doing upgrade. So first I need to create a volume in F5. That's why, because in hardware box, you will get by default HD hard disk one has 1.1 and 1.2. But here I am not having it. So I need to first do this way. So I need to create a volume. So I will do install sys software image. Then I need to define image. Then I will say create volume. Then I need to give volume. Volume HD 1.2. So my volume has been created. So guys, this is the command which I am running. Let me copy this and I will show you. Just give me 1 minute. Let me copy this in Notepad. So guys, this is the command which I run to create a volume. Install sys software image, my new image. Then I run create volume and new volume. This command is helpful to create a new volume through CLI. So let's see if volume has been created. So guys, can you see this? My new image is getting installed. And can you see the boot location? So it will take 5 to 10 minutes for installing new bootware image. It can take 10 to 15 minutes also. So it's, you will see the status also. So you go to details and you will see what it is happening. So you will see version, your build number, checksum, and where it's getting installed. And you can see the progress also. So once it's done, we just need to reboot it. That's the step we need to perform. So install will take some time. So right now it has completed. So you can see both the images 12.1.0 and 13.1.3 in installed image. Now it means my images are available. I just need to then install it, because now I need to upgrade into 12.1.0 to 13.1.3.5. So I have all the images installed. Now my next step is to upgrade this. So before upgrade, what I need to do is I will go, and my step is, what I need to do is, first, for precaution, I need to make this box. Let's say this is fifth step. I need to first force offline. So before upgrading, this is a very important step. So what I will do is, so that split brain does not happen. I will force offline this box. Then I will upgrade. I will go here. And I will make it active to just give me online. And I will just force offline. Now my box would be force offline. Now the step which comes is I need to change the active boot location. Right now my boot location which is there is SD 1.1. Now I need to upgrade it, so I need to change active boot location. So in this step I will change active boot location. This is next step. So where I need to go? So I will show you. So you will go to system, software management, then can you see this boot locations? So you will see one active and one as inactive. Because I need to upgrade from 12 to 13. Now I will go to boot location. And I will click on SD 1.2 and I will say, see, it will automatic live. Right now it's 12.1.0. Now I need to change into 13.1.3.5. And this is one step which is called install configuration. So generally you can do it, it will not harm you. So either you can do like, what is this? So first of all, this will do upgrade because I'm changing from 12.1.0 to 13.1. So I am changing the boot location from here. So, but there is one option which is called install configuration. So what does this install configuration means? So it will say that this configuration option will allow you to select a configuration to be installed. The same configuration which is present in 12, it will come here automatically. If you don't do it also, then it will not raise any issues. So it's saying that my source was this and my destination is 13. So it will select a configuration to be installed, which was activated. So that is what install configuration. So I will delete this. It's not necessary, so I will just activate. So you will get an option. Are you sure you want to boot into another volume? I will say okay. So see guys, now it will reboot and it will take 15 minutes. Most probably it can come in 10 minutes also. So you need to wait for some minutes and check whether it's booted up quickly. So let's see. So reboot is completed. My configuration utility is starting. So now it will take 1 or 2 minutes more before it comes up with latest version. So you can just go to command prompt and you can just ping it so that to make sure whether device is coming up. So right now my device is up, but UI is not up. So it will take some time. So let's say, let's check for some time. So it's rebooting in between, it takes some time. So once it's done, your upgrade is completed and you need to release offline. So it will take some time. So guys, now upgrade boot has been taken it. Let's see if this version is upgraded. I will go to configuration device. So guys, see, This version has been upgraded to 13.1.3.5, which means our upgrade of F5 is completed successfully. So I will, from here, our upgrade is completed. Now, what I need to do, this is our sixth step. Now, what I will do is I will force my active box to standby box, which is an upgraded version. Let's say this is upgraded to 13. So I will force to this and make it active. Then this will become standby. And I will follow this six steps again. That's all. And then we will test the new versions. This is very, very important. So right now this upgrade is completed and you are good to test your application on new version. If everything works fine, then it's okay. But if everything does not go fine, you need to roll back. So for rollback, what I showed is, let's say my version is 13 now. Right now my version is 13. Okay. But your customer is reporting issues and they do not have time to troubleshoot because it's a very business impacted customer. In that case, they want just a rollback. So how to roll back in 1 minute? So you need to run, you need to go to CLI and just go to Big IP, new one. And you need to just run this command, tmsh, then reboot volume, so HD 1.1, because in my HD, which version, in which HD my 12 version is. So you will be able to see from AM system software image. So when I will go to boot location HD 1.1, it will go to 12. So what I will do is I will just reboot volume HD 1.1. So this will roll back. This was all related to upgrade. Thanks.